It's the Gear Tester here with range report 3 on the Ruger 77-22 Magnum. I like this gun. The more I shoot it, the more I like it. It's an awesome rifle chambered in 22 Magnum. I've owned a number of 22 Magnums over the years. I do not own this particular gun. The two 22 Magnums that I've shot the most are the Marlin 983 and the Remington 597. Both those guns were accurate. Not nearly as accurate as this gun, but they are significantly cheaper. You can probably pick up both of those. Either one of those for probably under $400 or $500. This one runs about $700 without an optic. The Marlin 983 was tube-fed, and I had problems with the gun feeding reliably. Sometimes I have to reach into the action and kind of jiggle around to get it to go in. It didn't happen all the time, but it happened regularly enough that it became very annoying. And I sold that gun just because I was tired of dealing with those issues. It was a nice gun, the Marlin 983. Marlin manufactures a couple other versions of that same gun that actually have magazines, detachable box magazines. That's the Marlin 925 and the Marlin 982. They come with one, I believe, 4-round detachable magazine and one 7-round detachable magazine. You can purchase those. The Marlin line of 22 Magnum bolt-action rifles all seem to have 22-inch barrels. And they're good guns, but they're not nearly as accurate as this gun. If you want to see the accuracy potential of this gun, go and watch my range report 2 on the Ruger 77-22 Magnum. The other 22 Magnum that I owned was the Remington 597. A very good gun. I liked it. It was very accurate, probably more accurate, I think, than the Marlin 983 that I had. But the Remington 597 LSHB is what I believe they're calling the gun now. It's semi-automatic, and that's cool. It's very similar to a 10-22. The problem is it does not have these excellent rotary magazines. And that's where I believe the 77-22 Magnum comes into its own. These magazines are just awesome. They're reliable. They run. They pop in and out of the gun so easily. I haven't had any problems in the hundreds of rounds I've fired out of this gun. Pop right in easily. They're identical to the 10-22 magazines. They're just longer. And they hold 9 rounds instead of 10 rounds. And that's pretty awesome. The Marlin 597 has a detachable box magazine that's made out of metal or plastic. You can get either option, I believe, and it's a 10-shot metal magazine. However, I found that loading the magazine was extremely difficult. If you tried to push down, the magazine would jam up and take a long time to get the round out. You had to basically push backwards into the gun. They say it's a 10-round magazine. It ended up really only holding about 7 rounds, I found, if you wanted it to be reliable. And so I sold that gun as well just because it had accuracy. It also had problems when you ran a couple boxes, about 200 rounds, 150 rounds of 22 Magnum through it. If you didn't clean it, it would start having malfunctions. I actually had the gun have failures to fire where the bolt would chamber another round, but it wouldn't come in, so you'd pull the trigger, and firing pin would not actually strike the rim of the cartridge, and so you could pull the trigger, hear a click, and nothing would happen. So after those problems, I got rid of that gun. It was just not something I wanted to deal with. The Ruger 77-22 Magnum is an awesome gun. I've had no failures of fire, no problems with it. It's bolt action, and it's just an awesome gun. It is overall, this particular model is 39 inches. It has a 20-inch barrel, and it weighs 6.5 pounds. Before you mount an optic on it. You can also get it with stainless and a plastic stock. I really like the stainless model, but this walnut and this blued steel, man, that's beautiful with this excellent checkering. I really like it. Let's talk a little bit about the 22 Magnum cartridge. It's not just a glorified 22 long rifle round. It goes, for one thing, significantly faster. These AccuTips don't have a velocity on them, but these CCI Maxi-Mag 40 grain rounds do have a feet per second on it. It's a 1,875 feet per second. Your average 22 long rifle round is going about 1,200 feet per second. So you're getting 600 say 600-700 feet per second faster with these 40 grain ones, and I believe that these 33 grain ones are more like 2,000 feet per second. Another thing you get, so you don't just get velocity, you actually get a jacketed around. Most 22 long rifle rounds are basically coated or dipped in something, sometimes wax, sometimes kind of a copper coating, but they don't actually have a real jacket. 22 Magnum, it does have a real jacket on it. You actually have real brass there. So when that goes in, you get a much more devastating wound channel. So if you're going to be using this for hunting ground squirrels, raccoons, coyotes, in appropriate distances, I think this cartridge is far superior to a 22 long rifle. The Ruger 77 22 Magnum has the feel of a full-sized bolt-action rifle, a centerfire rifle, but you're able to shoot, you know, hundreds of rounds of ammunition for the price that you would shoot, you know, 20 or 30 rounds out of a 30-06 or a 308. You get a box of 22 Magnum for about $12-13. So I think it's kind of a steal. I really like shooting 22 Magnum. I like the cartridge. I really like this gun, the Ruger 77 22 Magnum. It's a beautiful rifle. The one thing, I borrowed this gun and I've shot it a lot, and I think I may have to go out and buy one, because I am really liking how accurate this rifle is, how easy it is to handle, and how much fun it is to shoot this rifle. The Ruger 77 22 Magnum. You can comment below. You can subscribe above. As always, thank you for your views and your subscriptions. If you like this video, you may want to go to one of my playlists or go to my channel and find other reviews of firearms and rifles and pistols and revolvers. I've got a couple other range reports on this excellent little rifle, along with some range reports on a rifle that's very similar to it, the Ruger 77 357 Magnum. Basically the same size, but chambered in the 357 Magnum cartridge. Thank you for your views and your subscriptions. This is the Gear Tester, signing off.